Kia ora koutou, hello and welcome to TVNZ's World Cup web chat. I think it's fair to say, todos estamos muy emocionados. We are all very excited for Argentina. Thrilled that they're through to the round of 16. There were some doubters out there. I, for one, was never one of them. Victor Waters, Jack Mabira with me this morning. Jack, are you surprised?
A little bit, maybe. Just, I wasn't sure how they were going to react. There was a lot of pressure on them, wasn't there, going into this game?
Yeah.
A lot of pressure on Messi's shoulders as well. Mm-hmm. But he came through. And then the first sort of, like 5 minutes, he scored, scored the goal.
They looked fantastic early on. The Argentine attack looked really strong. And that first touch of Messi's, La Pulga, the flea, he was incredible.
There's Messi in a nutshell. Just he can control it. You can smash at him. He'll control it. Put it down. Put it top corner. Bottom.
I tell you what, it was a nerve-wracking little period there, though, because we had the Icelandic match on, Iceland-Croatia at the same time as the Argentina-Nigeria match. And for the rest of the match, Argentina did not look at all confident. There was a penalty call which could have gone either way.
Yeah, I mean, I understand why the ref didn't give it. I mean, Rojo can't cut his arm off when he's heading the ball down onto his arm, but I've seen those given. Argentina lucky, but look, you need luck. Messi said God is with us, and that is why we are in the round of 16.
Yeah, and they even went to the VAR, and I thought he might actually give that penalty at that stage as well. So it was an interesting call, but yeah, I guess he didn't move his arm to go for the ball, and he's kind of in the air. But it's a messy header, isn't it?
So, yeah.
Could go either way.
Every cloud for those of us who are celebrating Argentina, because I've got to say, Iceland has shown a whole lot of heart this World Cup, haven't they?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, like they did at the Euros as well, you know, their fans have been terrific. They've been great value. It's a shame for them not to kind of push on. And perhaps they haven't quite hit the heights that they did at the Euros in this competition.
Oh, look. Iceland are Iceland. They've done well. They should be proud of their efforts. But that's football. That's World Cup. That is what it is.
Right. So Croatia finished top of Pool D. Let's talk about France very quickly. They stuttered a little bit against the Danes this morning, the first nil-all draw of the Cup.
Yeah, but I think, you know, there wasn't much riding on that game, right? They were already kind of through. Perhaps they took their foot off the gas a little bit, you know, maybe resting for a big clash in the last 16. So it's difficult, really, to make too many judgments on them, I think, based on that result.
Yeah, we've got Croatia-Denmark squaring off in the round of 16, and France-Argentina, that's going to be an incredible match.
That's a really tight match. France probably have, arguably, in terms of depth, probably one of the best squads, all round defence, midfield, attack. But Argentina have Messi, and when you have Messi, anything is possible.
Yeah, another fantastic day at this 2018 World Cup. Join us again tomorrow for TVNZ's World Cup web chat. Delen, hei konnera.